Jason lives. Yes, he does. People with the Friday the 13th, Jason Part 6, Jason Lives. Jason Voorhees gets a new leash on life and a little more humor. Once again, it's a comfort food for slasher soul. Tommy Jarvis is back for another round with Jason Voorhees at the opening. Tommy and one of his friends creep into an old gothic graveyard to dig the body of Jason Voorhees. Tommy wants a closure by burning the body, but unfortunately, as usual, things don't go according to plan, and Jason is resurrected by a lightning bolt. Yeah, like Frankenstein. So now Jason Voorhees is no longer a superhuman. Now he's a supernatural zombie, if you will. As Tommy's friend gets his heart punched out by a cranky Jason, Tommy races to the local police to warn them, but no one believes the poor tormented Tommy about the newly resurrected psycho killer. So he decides to take matters into his own hands. Along the way, he has the run-in with the sheriff, and he falls for the sheriff's daughter. Megan, who falls for Tommy, is played by Megan Crook. Megan also just so happens to be a counselor for a group of small children at the newly remained Camp Forest Green, which used to be Camp Crystal Lake. Uh-oh. The writer and director, Tom, packs his fun script with ironic references to the genre and its audience. At one point, a grave digger turns to the camera as he refills Jason's grave and says, "Some folks have a strange idea of entertainment." There are funny visual puns. A kid in the camp sleeps with a copy of Gene Paul's Starters No Exit trucked loving next to him. And there are no witty one-liners. One wise-ass kid turns into another as they prepare for the carnage that is Jason Voorhees and asks, "What were you going to be when you grew up?" Jason Lives certainly delivers in terms of entertainment, but for all the humor, McLaurin never lets us forget that we're watching a Jason movie. Iconic images of our favorite slasher abound, whether he's walking through a forest in daylight, taking down paintballers, or posting on a burning truck with a machete in his hands. Wonderful stuff. McLaurin and his director's commentary and the making of the documentary talks about this iconic humor, which predates movies like Scream. And he seems generally proud of his entry to the mythos. Into the Extra Terms of Paramount offers up the aforementioned commentary track of making a documentary, a series of slash screens, and artistic interception of an ending that McLaurin proposed for a movie where we all get to meet Jason's father, a new twist for fans. Friday the 13th, Part 6, Jason Lives gets a 7.5 out of 10. This is a very entertaining movie and one you need to check out. This is Red Wolf signing out, and I'll see you next time. Peace.